Faithfulness. Faithfulness. Praise God. Faithfulness. I pray that from today you will learn how to be faithful. Amen. You will learn how to be faithful. Many a times we allow greed, pride, desire to fail, motivate us. Many people who are in a big position today is because of what greed, fail, pride that has put them there. Many people fail because of this. Last week we studied about people who were able to become successful in ministry, people who were failed, and people were able to turn their failures into something. Amen. We need to learn how to turn any failure that comes our way into something. Amen. We need to turn them to something. We need to turn them to something. Christian, last week at secret of success. Secret of success. Secrets of Success. These are very powerful truths I'm sharing with you this morning. You are blessed. You see, God wants you to be successful in ministry. He wants you to be successful in your marriage. He wants you to be successful in your career. Many of us are not only going to be in ministry. For me, I'm not only going to be in ministry. I'm going to do corporate business as well. Amen. Daddy is a banker. He's not going to be in ministry alone. Many of you have other businesses you do. So you must be successful in all those areas. You must be successful in all the areas that you put yourself in. Amen. I love and I wish that you not too many full time for now. Until you get to a time where your attention is needed and you can't do any other thing. Even with that, you can still write books. Amen. You can still write books. You can still hold seminars, conferences. Amen. In the early years, we made many of the money for conferences. We hold seminars for pastors and God bless us through that. Amen. So God wants you to be successful in everything you do. So we need to be able to learn secrets of success. Number one secret, have a proper heart attitude. Have a proper heart attitude. That's the first secret of success that we need. Have a proper heart attitude. What is the condition of your heart? The King Saul was rejected because of the condition of his heart. David was chosen as a king because of the condition of his heart. When God sent the prophet Samuel to go to the house of Jesse to anoint the king, Samuel went there and saw the other sons of Jesse and thought, because of their height and countenance, God wants them to be king. And God told him, I have rejected them. If a man always looks at what you dress, what you wear, the way you look, gentle, your charisma, but God doesn't look at charisma, look at character. And character is what you are inside. Character is what you are inside. And charisma is what you are outside. Amen. Your character is what you are inside, which are the characteristics of God. It is what you are inside, and your charisma is what you are outside. Many a times we go with our charisma. People look at us for our charisma. Hey, this man is very charismatic. This man is very nice. Oh, this man is very good. But inwardly, the conditions of our heart are not pure. The conditions of our heart are not good. They are not kind. They are the conditions that God can use. Amen. The attitude of our heart determines the magnitude that we can go. Amen. Let me say it again. The attitude of our heart determines the magnitude and the length that we can go. What is the condition of the heart? Amen. We need to have a proper heart attitude. If we really want to go deep in ministry, if we really want to succeed in ministry, if we really want to be successful in ministry, we need a proper heart and ask yourself the condition of your heart. Amen. Ask yourself the condition of your heart. It is a success begins with a hidden man. The hidden man in you. That's where your success begins.
Amen.
1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 7. As I was talking about Samuel, 1 Samuel 15, 7. It says, "For the Lord heareth not as man heareth, for man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart." God looks on the heart. Man looks on the outward appearance. In fact, if you are coming to me for an interview, or if you are questioning and you are not properly dressed, I will not pass you. I will fail you. Why? Because I will look at the outward appearance. Until I live with you, until I work with you, before I begin to know what is inside of you. Amen? So take note. God knows the condition of your heart. Because He has predestinated you before you were born. Amen? So the condition of your heart is very good. Right? A proper heart attitude includes love, humility, obedience, a servant spirit, and a true holiness. It includes love, humility, obedience, a servant spirit, and a true holiness. And a proper heart attitude includes love, humility, obedience, a servant spirit, and a true holiness. So we must love the Lord. We must love what we do. We must be humble, humility. We must be humble. Hallelujah. We must be obedient to the word of God. We must have a servant spirit. As I told you this morning, when Reverend and I came here, we know what he has to do. We have to put the place in order. Amen. We have a servant spirit. We are not those who are arrogant, who maybe fold their arms at their back, begin to jump like some eagles from somewhere, and expect someone to come with you. No. You need a servant spirit. Amen. You need a servant spirit. A true holiness. Let me stress on this. Holiness is very important. Amen. You can't have a right hand because it's not holy. Holiness is very important. Number two. Know the source of sacrifices for me. Know the source of sacrifice. Know the source of sacrifice. Something of the